then want to talk to you about this event, the Raise Your Flag event, commemorating 1 year until the World Junior Championships. First of all, you guys unveiled your logo today. I know that was a big moment for you guys. What went into this logo design?
Well, you know, whenever you're trying to agree on one thing, you end up with a lot of people that have a lot of different ideas. And in the end, it was trying to be representative of the state of Oregon. It was trying to be representative of the East Grandstands and the Bowerman Curve. So we were able to get it all on there.
The 2014 World Junior Track and Field Championships, an event that maybe a lot of people aren't familiar with, but this is essentially the best young athletes in the world that are coming to Hayward Field next year. What should people look forward to for this event?
You know, this is an event that has, you know, if you take a look at since 2002, athletes who have won medals at the World Junior Championships have also gone on to win medals at the Olympic Games. This is an opportunity to get an early look at the best and most promising juniors in the world.
One of those guys is standing by, Jesse Williams. I know a lot of the local American stars competed in the World Juniors. Do you see this as a way to also maybe see the next generation of track town stars, of people that we'll be seeing running in Eugene for years to come?
No doubt. This is an opportunity for not only, I think we have something special there. You know, these athletes have something special, and I think the opportunity for them to compete at iconic Hayward Field and an opportunity to really enjoy their experiences here is something spectacular.
Logistically, how does this stack up to the track and field trials? 212 countries, there's going to be a lot of athletes here. From a logistics standpoint, how do you get all those people into Hayward Field?
Well, I think that the issue is not going to necessarily be the number of people in Hayward Field. It's the number of people who need to live in this community for 6 days. And to find entertainment for kids below the age of 20 is going to be quite a challenge, but I believe Tracktown staff is up to it.
I think they can do it. Thank you very much, Vin. And now we'll bring in Jesse Williams. Jesse, the reigning world champion high jumper. Thanks for joining me, Jesse. And when you were a kid, you competed in the World Junior Championships in Kingston, Jamaica. What was that experience like for you as a young up-and-coming track and field athlete?
Really brought on the international stage of competing for me. I never really competed against anybody from all over the world, everybody from all over the world, and that was my first time, and it was so special just seeing everybody from all these different countries come together and compete as one.
How did that springboard your career? Do you look back on that event as a big moment in your career?
Yeah, it really just opened up my eyes to see how big the sport could be. I mean, it was a big, big event. It was the highest you could achieve at that age. So I just remember walking into the stadium and just getting chills. And every time I still walk into big events like a World Championships or Olympics, I think of every event that got me there, and that was a starting point.
Usain Bolt won gold as a 15-year-old in Kingston, Jamaica when you were there. Yeah. Do you remember watching him as a 15-year-old, and do you think back to seeing what he did then and now where he's at is maybe one of the most iconic athletes in the world?
Right. No, it was unbelievable. I remember people were making shirts of this 15-year-old guy. Everybody they had a lightning bolt, and they called him the Bolt. You know, they all had the Jamaican accents, the Bolt, we'll do this. And it was unbelievable. 15-year-old on that stage, and he came through with the win at an athlete at that age, 15 years old, to win the World Juniors was unheard of.
Now we get to see maybe the next Usain Bolt coming here to Tracktown in Eugene next summer. How big of an event is it for the track and field culture, the track and field fans of this town?
Well, I know that they haven't had a World Championship event in track and field in the United States since 1989 as a World Indoor Championships. And that's a long time ago, 24 years right now, 25 next year. So, you know, it's really special to have an event like this, especially here in the Eugene area and, I mean, in the United States in general.
It should be an awesome event. And I want to get to you a little bit. 2 years ago in Daegu, you won gold in the high jump. Now getting ready for Moscow. Where are you at in your preparations for this year's World Championship?
Unfortunately, I had a pretty severe foot injury, and I'm still on the mend. I'm in really great shape, but it's hard to take off from it. So I'm just hoping to get some good treatment here in the next few weeks and hopefully surprise some people there.
Good luck in Moscow, Jesse.
I appreciate it.
Jesse Williams and Vin Lanana, as we are just 1 year to the day away from the beginning of the World Junior Track and Field Championships right here in Eugene at Hayward Field, July 22nd, 2014. The next big event to come to Tracktown. live at Oakway Center in Eugene. I'm Jake Sivan. Back to you.